Hello everyone. In today's video, I am going to speak about the malnutrition miracle, ready to use therapeutic food. Malnutrition is projected to cause more than one third of all child's death, although it is rarely listed as the direct cause. Lack of access to highly nutritious food is a common cause of malnutrition. Poor feeding practices such as inadequate breastfeeding, offering the wrong foods, and not ensuring that the child gets enough nutritious food contribute to malnutrition. Frequent or persistent infections is also a cause for child's malnutritional status. Ready-to-use therapeutic food was designed by research scientist Andrew Bryan and Nutricer, a private company making nutritional products for humanitarian relief. Our U2F is high in energy and protein with added electrolytes, minerals and vitamins, specially designed to need to treat severe acute malnutrition. It is equivalent to F100 in terms of nutrition per 100 kilocalories. It does not have to be mixed with water, and so it is microbiologically safe and enables treatment in the community. What is the composition of RUTF? It is no wonder that RUTF is often referred as a miracle food. RUTF is a tasty, energy-packed paste made from peanuts, oil, sugar, milk powder, vitamin, and mineral supplements. RUTF is a peanut butter amplifier contained in a package that looks like an oversized ketchup packet. One packet that is 92 grams of RUTF contains 500 calories of therapeutic food. It is used by UNICEF as most effective tool for treating acute and severe acute malnutrition throughout the world. How long does a child need to eat RUTF? A malnourished child needs to eat 10 to 15 grams of RUTF over a period of 6 to 8 weeks per day, 3 packets of RUTF per day. The first 1,000 days of a child's life are crucial and can determine that child's full growth prospects, and is much essential to provide RUTF to starving children. The advantage of RUTF is that it is ready-to-use paste which need not be mixed with water. According to the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, 98% of children treated with RUTF were well-nourished after 6 months, and 96% were well-nourished after a year. What makes RUTF different from family foods and other feeds fed to severely malnourished children? RUTFs do not need cooking and do not need to be mixed with water. The high fat content and low moisture prevents bacterial growth, which means that they are microbiologically safer than feeds prepared with water. RUTF will keep for several months in simple packaging. Electrolytes and micronutrients are added during production, whereas these need to be provided as supplements when using family foods. In an issue of Indian Pediatrics, Dubey et al. Have compared the acceptability and nutrient contents of an imported RUTF with khichdi, that is rice and green gram gruel, a routine food given to our Indian children. This study documents that both the foods were accepted well by the malnourished children. However, the number of observations were small to make adequate interpretation. Dubey et al. Has concluded that we need a cautious approach while importing RUTF to India, as our administration system is porous and there is a chance of commercial exploitation of malnutrition by vested interests. They may ensure continued high imports of RUTF in the name of treatment of children with severe acute malnutrition to ensure that the development of indigenous RUTF is delayed. Thanks for watching.